Hello, my name is Dr. Antin, and over here is the world's first loudspeaker that's printed using the Desktop Metal Forust method. This loudspeaker is called CX1 because it's a coaxial unit, the first one we've designed with a coaxial principle. But the feature that makes this loudspeaker special is the enclosure material. So let's talk about that first. The Desktop Metal Forust method is a binder jetting process where sawdust is selectively bonded together using bioepoxy in a layer by layer method, and that way we can build up a three-dimensional structure. The manufacturing settings here included an artificial wood texture, so it has a layer by layer structure but also a layer by layer coloring, so you get this plywood kind of appearance. Now, for some reason, the marketing departments of companies producing wood-filled 3D printing materials insist that the parts are post-processable using the same methods as wood. In none of the cases have we found that this would be true. The parts produced using the Desktop Metal Forust method are easier to sand than 100% plastic, but the rest of the post-processing resembles mostly plastic. For example, this does not absorb wood stain. If you have a coarse surface like sandblasted or sanded with a coarse grit sandpaper, you might get some wood stain to stick in the crevices and the scratches, but it does not absorb wood stain. We wet sanded these parts, and the following day we noticed some brown residue where water had pooled. So that confirms what Desktop Metal Forust is saying, that this is not for outdoor use. This loudspeaker does not contain a crossover. Instead, it has a 4-pin speak-on connector in the back, and then you can use your active crossover and bi-amp it. The recommended crossover frequency is 2 kHz. The shape of the enclosure allows this to be placed on its side also. For example, if you're using it as a center channel and you have a screen above it, you might want the lower profile. How does it sound? Well, obviously, not a lot of bass from a 15 centimeter unit in a 3-liter sealed enclosure. The tweeter is definitely of high quality. It's an aluminium dome. I like the clarity that it offers. We have a faceplate here covering up the flange. It's not good for diffraction. The next version will be with the driver flush mounted. The diffraction issues we found are actually quite interesting because they do not show up in the on-axis amplitude response. Instead, you can hear the difference quite clearly when you cup the driver like this and take your hands away. It's the same effect that the faceplate is doing here. So in conclusion, the Desktop Metal Forust method is certainly an interesting one, especially the visual appearance that is the closest thing to wood that we have in the 3D printing world yet. But we have to keep in mind that this is not exactly wood. It's not a drop-in material replacement for wood. We're not there quite yet. Nevertheless, we are looking forward to the future.